Hey, how you doing? I'm Scott Dunsheath, and I'm the owner of a brand called Reno Envy.
So Scott, tell me about this aha moment that came to you that gave you this whole Reno idea.
Well, a friend of mine many years ago asked me what my address was, and I told him Scott Dunsheath, 6855 Diamond Glen, Reno Envy, 89523. And we both realized at that moment that the state abbreviation for Nevada, NV, sounded just like the word envy.
Kind of reminds me of penis envy.
That's funny. You're not the only one. Yeah, when I told my mom about this whole idea, this Reno Envy idea, she went and started telling her friends, oh, you know, my son's got this great idea. It's called Reno Envy. And she's like, you know, it's like penis envy. And I'm like, no, mom, it's not like penis envy. I mean, the last thing you want to hear your mom say is the P words.
That's what went through my mind. I hate to admit that, but that's what went through my mind, because the only envy I had ever heard of before in my whole life was the P word, envy. Yes.
I think what makes our brand unique is the sense of discovery. It's when people have that moment when they figure out that Reno Envy plays off our state abbreviation for Nevada, NV. It's like, ooh, I figured it out. I'm in the club. I get it. And then they're like, oh, do you know what it means? Do you get it? Reno Envy, do you get it? Do you get it? Do you get it? It's funny, it's great, and I think it's what really attracts people to our brand. So people are always asking us, what's up with the trailer? Well, the trailer is the symbol of the Reno Envy brand. When we started this company, we really didn't know what direction we wanted to go or who we were. So we started doing knockoff stuff, parody stuff, clearly a John Deere shirt. Well, we thought, hey, what can we put in there instead of the deer? Like, we'll put a trailer, that'll be funny, you know, for one shirt. Well, we did that shirt, and the idea stuck. People fell in love with that trailer. So because of that, it became the symbol of the brand. We started Reno Envy in 2005. Before that, I worked in the action sports industry for 12 years. The last 8 of those years, I worked for Vans as their Northern California sales rep. In 2006, I left the industry to pursue my passion and to follow my dream and to focus on Reno Envy full time. Our first store was in 2008.
Okay.
The start of the recession is when I opened up my first retail store.
Okay.
Yeah, so not the brightest move on my part.
Uh-huh.
But in any case, we survived. It was 300 square feet and it was at the West Street Market. We were there for 2.5 years. And last summer, we moved to this location, which is on Sierra Street, one of the main streets in Reno. And we went from 300 square feet to 600 square feet. And then this summer, we expanded from 600 to 1,800 square feet. There's not a lot of retail in downtown Reno. We're one of the only retail stores. There's other places that we could have gone, you know, some of the strip malls, but it was really important for us as a brand, as a Reno brand, to be in the heart of downtown Reno. The RSCVA and Reno Envy partnered, and we reached out to the city of Reno and said, hey, we've got this wacky, crazy idea about putting a visitor center inside of our store. What do you think? Well, the city of Reno loved the idea. They own the building that we're in. So the three of us partnered, Reno Envy, the RSCVA, and the city of Reno. And this summer, we opened up the official and only Reno Tahoe Visitor Center in downtown Reno. It's cool. Like, I love Reno. I've been in Reno for 25 years. And the idea that we've created a brand that other Renoites connect with, it's super cool. You know, it never gets old walking down the street and seeing people with a Reno Envy shirt. Weekly, we get businesses coming to me saying, hey, you know, will you make us some t-shirts? We want to co-brand with you. We want to work with you. We want to be part of this. Like, we've created something that people want to connect to. And to me, that's the most rewarding thing.
When you see somebody down the street and they're wearing one of these shirts, you know they're part of the gang.
Well, what we've done with Reno Envy is we have built a community around a brand by building a brand around a community. And we're confident that we can do the same thing in downtown Vegas. Reno and Vegas are so similar in so many different ways.
we've done something here that matters, that people connect with.
So great to have a store like this here in town.
So everyone's familiar with the I Heart New York shirt, right? Locals love it, tourists love it. If you go to New York, it's the shirt that you have to have. Well, we want to take the Vegas Envy line and position ourselves the same way. We want to be the locals' favorite. We want to be the tourists' favorite. If you go to Vegas, you'll want to pick up a Vegas Envy shirt. When someone else instead of me always seems to know the way. So I would like to thank the Downtown Project for taking the time to watch my video. I've always been interested in wordplay and jumbles. So here is a great thing that you guys can do. It's a lot of fun. It's a little game that we like to play. Take your first name or your first and last name, cut up some letters, and see what kind of words you can make out of your name. So my last name is Dunsheath. Check this out. Nuthead. Well, I took the liberty of taking Tony's name and trying to figure out what kind of word I can make out of that. In thy shoe, my friend. In thy shoe. I'll see you in Vegas.